喜びのプログラムにしましょうか。最初はちょっと歌ね、サハジャヨガの歌、グループで歌います。それと後でこのちょっとイントロダクションのサハジャヨガ話します。それとシマタジ来ますので、私の日本語全然ダメだから、強くないと思います。As you read in the pamphlet, you can see the chakras, and that's the way you're going to find in the meditation. You're going to discover the chakras.
パンフレットでご覧になったと思いますけれども、そこにチャートが載っております。そのチャートは、メディテーションを通していろいろとこれから発見していくものでございます。
That's your inner system, your subtle system.
それがあなたの内なるシステム、サトルシステム、精妙なるシステムです。
It's called the chakras and the channels.
それはチャカラ、そして、経路というふうに呼ばれているものです。
You have three channels, the hot channel, the cold channel, and the center.
三つの経路がございます。熱い経路、冷たい経路、そして真ん中の経路がございます。
And then you have seven centers, né, of energy, seven chakras, from down to the top.
そして七つのセンター、エネルギーの中心が下から一つずつ七つございます。
And that's the story of evolution also comes in that evolution of chakras, you know?
それが進化の物語とも言えますし、一つの進化を表しております。
In the first step of evolution, you have the inner sense.
まず、進化の第一歩が純真です。
And then you have the creativity where everything starts to be created.
次に創造性、いろんなものが創造されていく段階です。
Is the second Swadhisthana chakra.
それが第二番目のチャクラのSwadhisthana chakraと呼ばれるものです。
Then in the third step of evolution, you haveAll the material well-being is formed. It's where you can eat, you can find food and rewards in the material aspect of life.
そして3番目のセンターが、その人間の物質的な面に、とても関連のある面です。食べ物に、関して、そして物質に関してです。
That's where the animals they stop in that level.
動物はこの段階でその進化は止まっております。
And then it comes the fourth center is the heart chakra. It's where you start having feelings.
そして4番目のチャクラに来ますと、私たちは感情を持つようになります。
This is in brief, you know, there are more things also in these chakras, but in brief, here is where your feelings, you know, and the father and the mother, you know, relationship.
今お話ししているのは本当に簡単なことしか触れておりませんけれども、母親の面、父親の面、そしてそういった感情的な面をそのセンター、4番目のハートのセンターが関連あります。
And then you come to the fifth center, is the Vishuddhi chakra, is blue.
そして5番目のセンターが Vishuddhi chakra と呼ばれております。青く、書かれているところです。
Is where the human being starts communicating. He can sing, he can talk.
そしてこのセンターでは人間が、コミュニケーション、人とのコミュニケーションが始められたところです。歌ったり話したり、そういったことです。
And then you come to the sixth center, is the Ajna chakra, where the human being starts also thinking. They can use their thoughts to create things, to solve problems, you see.
そして6番目のセンター、まあ、こちらのセンターですけども、人間が思考を始めた、考えを始めたところです。考えることによって、思考することによって、人間は想像したりしたわけです。
But it doesn't stop here. It has the seventh chakra, and is the latest, the last step of evolution in human beings. It's where you have the contacts with another dimension.
そして、ここの6番目のセンターで、人間は止まらないわけです。もっと最終的なステップがあります。それが、7番目のセンター、進化の最終的ステップです。ここにおいて人間はコネクションが、つながりが初めてもたらされます。
That's the state of joy.
それが喜びの状態です。
That's the state of meditation, actually, satori.
それがメディテーション、瞑想の状態、悟りの状態です。
And in that level of meditation, you also get connected with the divine knowledge, is the knowledge of everything.All that was created in the world.
そしてここにおいて神聖なる知識とのつながりが初めてここでもたらされます。
That's why in Sahaja Yoga we say that you have to discover.
ですから、Sahaja Yoga ではあなたが自分で発見していかなければいけませんというふうに言います。
You are your own master.
あなたがあなた自身のマスターです。導き手となるわけです。
And being your own master also is nice to have somebody that can teach you something also.
そして自分が自分のマスターになるにあたって誰かがあなたにいろいろ教えてくださる方がいるということはとても良いことです。
Somebody that have that deep knowledge of meditation, for example.
深い知識を持っておられる、瞑想において深い知識を持っておられる方との、まあ、コンタクトがあるということが、良いと思われます。
And somebody also that can be like your own mother, that teach you.Like your own mother always teach you. It's somebody that can teach you also in that other level of awareness.
その方が、自分のお母さんのように、違った次元でのものをあなたに教えてくださる、そういった方がおられるということです。
And that knowledge has no, monetary value.Because it's the knowledge of the divine. It's completely free. It's the knowledge of the world.
その知識においては金銭的なものは全く関係はございません。それは、世界の知識ということですので、
So, before starting the program, we would like to sing two songs for you, using this Indian instruments. Would you like to listen? So we have a little group of Sahaj yogis, and we are going to sing. One song is for Sri Ganesha, that's the elephant god, and the other song for the goddess Vishwavandita.
プログラムを進める前にここで、2つ曲を、皆さんにお送りしたいと思います。こちらに、見られますインドの楽器を使います。小さなグループで、歌うので、皆さん聴いてください。まず最初の歌は、ガネシャストゥティといって、シュリガネーシャに、象の神に捧げる歌、そして2番目は、女神に捧げる歌です。
Also, just a little parenthesis, in Sahaja Yoga, the children also meditate. And that's why, you know, my son is like that. I'm sorry.
Sahaja Yoga では子供も瞑想します。ですから、私の子供もこのようにちょっとちょろちょろとしておりますけども、すいませんです。
Okay, let's sing that two songs, please.
では歌いますので聞いてください。
Thank you. Vishwavandita.
Thank you.
vantagi.
Yes, it is on the stream, Mataji.
I bow to all the seekers of truth. At the very outset, we have to know that truth is what it is. We cannot change it. We cannot transform it. And at this human awareness, we cannot know it. If we had known the Absolute Truth, there would have been no problems. But you see, we have so many ideologies, so many theories. All kinds of religions. Just to fight with each other. If you know the Absolute Truth, there cannot be a difference of opinion. For example, I am sitting before you. You know I am sitting before you, there's no difference of opinion about it. That means something more has to happen to us. In our evolutionary process, we have become human beings. But it's not sufficient. Now people talk of peace. But if there is no peace within, how can you create peace? Is it all right? It's falling down. It's very heavy, I think. Ah, it's better. When I am talking to you, you should not accept me blindfolded. We have had lots of problems with blind faith. But if it is proved, then you have to accept as honest people. Because it is for your benevolence, for the benevolence of your family, for the benevolence of your country, and for the benevolence of the whole world. You have been already told about this power which is within us. Once awakened, like a primule in the seed, it rises into six centers. And then pierces through your fontanel bone area All this to know the truth. Truth is that you are not this body, this mind. These emotions, this intelligence, this ego, these conditionings. But you are the pure spirit. Now we see these beautiful flowers here. It's a miracle. But we take it for granted. If you ask a doctor, who runs your heart? He will say it is autonomous nervous system. But who is this auto? So the another truth is that there is an all-pervading power of divine love. Which does all these miraculous things. So when your Kundalini, which is your own mother, rises and pierces through your fontanel bone area, you feel this all-pervading power on your fingertips. And you become the spirit. I must say, in Japan, traditionally you have been very introspective. I've been coming to Japan with my husband before. And your Zen system of meditation is the same about which I'm talking to you. They talked of self-realization. So traditionally you are very rich. But with materialism, perhaps all our attention has gone outside. Countries like Sweden, Switzerland, which are supposed to be materially very rich, they are all competing in committing suicide. Because there is no peace within. Matter cannot give us joy. The principle of economics that wants in general are not satiable. Today you want to have a house, then a car, then television, goes on like that. Because these are not pure desires. Whether you know or not, the pure desire is to be one with this all-pervading power. This is the vital power. Vital power. This is the vital power. Vital. Essential for life. Now, when you become the Spirit, it's very interesting to know what happens to you. Firstly, your attention gets enlightened by the Spirit. This attention gives you divine discretion. You understand what is good for you and what is bad for you. Sahaja Yoga has cured many people who used to suffer from drug addiction and all such things which were destructive. Because you mature to see what's wrong, what's good for you. Now, we are all the time thinking about the past and the future. We cannot be in the present. But the past is finished. And the present you cannot feel. You just think of the future. Future doesn't exist. What is reality is the present. But we don't live in the present. When the Kundalini rises, these thoughts are put aside. And a space is created, which is the present. In the present, you are without any thoughts, but fully aware. That is the state we call as thoughtless awareness. Where you don't think. If you want, you can think. If you don't want, you need not think. That is the principle of Zen. So when you see something, you just watch, you are a witness. At that stage you become absolutely peaceful. For example, you are standing in the water. You are afraid of the waves. But supposing you get onto a boat, then you can watch these waves and enjoy them. They won't disturb you. But supposing you jump in the water as a swimmer, you can save so many people. In this way, in spirituality, you grow in two stages. The first one, where you are thoughtlessly aware. And the second one is called as doubtlessly aware. You are aware, fully aware, but you have no doubts. Doubts about yourself and doubts about your divinity. And then you realize how glorious you are. How peaceful you are. And how powerful you are. You are filled with compassion. This all-pervading power is the ocean of knowledge, absolute knowledge, is the ocean of miracles, ocean of bliss, but above all, it is the ocean of forgiveness. So you don't have to condemn yourself. If you are earnestly seeking the truth, it's a right that you have got that you should get your realization. All these centers are for your physical, mental and emotional being. And above for your spiritual being. When these centers go into jeopardy, you have problems. If you can cure these centers, you get all right. Also, you can feel the centers of others. So there is another awareness, another dimension of awareness that comes to you. That we call as collective consciousness. That means we can feel the centers of others on our fingertips. I have to tell you that in Delhi University, three doctors have got their MD with Sahaj Yoga. For curing incurable diseases. When the Kundalini rises, she nourishes all these centers and thus very incurable diseases are cured. By your own energy, by yourself. After your self-realization, you become a peaceful personality. Very creative and extremely compassionate. It's very relaxing and you get rid of all these modern problems of stress and strain. I am 72 years of age and I am traveling every day. I came yesterday from Sydney and tomorrow I am going back to Hong Kong. It's all right because I don't think I travel. Just I'm sitting here, I'm sitting in the plane. So with this new awareness of collective consciousness, we can feel others on our fingertips. Who is the other? They become the part and parcel of your own being. You can cure other people, you can raise their kundalini and give them self-realization. We have so many powers within us, so many potential powers which are awakened. It's nothing outside, it's all inside. When we start practicing goodness outside, we become fanatic. Because it's not mental. It is beyond the mind. I've met many people who have got awards for peace, who have got peace organizations. But they are very hot-tempered people, extremely hot-tempered. Those who have no peace within, how can they give peace to others? But when you become self-realized, you emit peace to others. In the society, in your country. Of course, Indians know about it, so it has worked very much there. But surprisingly, it has worked best in Russia. They were communists, you see, and they have no materialistic attitude. I don't say communism is good, but even democracy is also demonocracy. Communism, if it is suppression, democracy is absolute licentious permission. The culture of West is very dangerous. It is ruining the people in the West. As a result, these fanatics of Islam and all that have started another movement to suppress. But by suppression, morality cannot come. Nor by giving freedom. You have to take to the middle path and not to go to extremes. That is only possible when you become the spirit. In such culture, we don't have any suppression. The people have their own discretion and they know what is good for them. As it is, you can find it's very difficult even to follow Christ. Christ was a great soul, very great incarnation. But he didn't know what sort of human beings he was facing. He said in Bible, in the 5th chapter of Matthew's, that if you use your eyes, one of the eyes is doing a sinful thing, then take out the eyes, your own. If your hand is doing, right hand is doing something wrong, cut out the hand. These are rules and regulations for angels, not for normal human beings. I have been to all the Christian nations, I have not seen even one person without one eye or without one arm. Then came Islam. So perhaps Muhammad Sahib thought that Christ was strict on men, why not be strict about women? So he said, any woman who looks at another man with a bad intention should be buried halfway in the Mother Earth and should be stoned. Imagine women in America, all of them will be under the earth. Because they are all the time divorcing their husbands. Also he's got this Shariat. Actually, it was Moses who brought the Shariat for the Jews. It's in the book of Jeremiah, in the Bible. But Jews thought it was too much, so they wouldn't accept it anymore. But Muhammad Sahib accepted it. I should tell you that in the north of India we have lots of Islamic culture. Under that influence their women are suppressed, they have to cover their heads, cover their faces, even Hindus. But the immorality is so great there that I don't know the suppression can bring in such horrible immorality.
Immorality
Once I was traveling from Riyadh to London. And I went off to sleep. But when I woke up, I found all the people were changed. The men were wearing very dandy type of dresses. She said, no. I said, then what about these people, from where have they come? She said, these are the same. They have taken out their chadar, and the men have taken out all their headgears, and now you see they are the same, in the plane. They did not even wait to go to London. So these religions are not meant for ordinary human beings, normal human beings. I think these are meant for angels. First the human beings have to become angels. They have to get their self-realization. Then only they will realize their value. Then I don't have to tell you, don't. You will yourself know what is not good for you. For example, supposing there's darkness here and I'm very obstinate and I have a snake in my hand. And you tell me there's a snake in your hand, I'm not going to believe you because I'm obstinate. Till the snake bites me, I will not leave it. But as soon as there is some light, I'll throw away the snake. In the same way, when you have light of the spirit, your attention, you become your own guide, your own master. This is absolutely simple. Because already you've got this power within you. You have to only have faith in yourself. Also, pure desire, earnest desire to become the spirit. Because it is your own power. This bone where it is placed called sacrum, means the Greek knew it was a sacred bone. Sahaja means, saha means with, ja means born. Born with you is this power to achieve the state of selfhood. So now it will take hardly 15 minutes for you to get your realization. I must tell you that to Japan I came very late for this work. I am here only for the second time. And I apologize for that. But Sahaja Yoga is working in 65 nations. I am sure with your understanding and wisdom, you will respect your self-realization. And grow into it. You cannot pay for it. It's a living process. How much did we pay for our evolution? Those people who take money in the name of God or in the name of knowledge are actually selling themselves. So now, I think you should be pleasantly placed towards yourself. It will take only 15 minutes. It is very simple, I thought, and is your own. You are not obliged to anyone. There are three conditions which are very simple. The first one is that you have to have full confidence in yourself. That means you should not feel guilty about anything. Whatever mistakes you have committed in the past is over now. At this moment you shouldn't worry about that. Whenever you commit mistakes, of course, you should face it. But what's the use of thinking about what has happened in the past? So not to feel guilty at all. If you feel guilty, then the center on the left-hand side catches very much. And you can develop a disease called angina of the heart. Or you can develop what they call as spondylitis. Or might be lethargic organs. So what's the use of feeling guilty? It's a myth. Actually it's a fashion also. I don't know about present day Japanese, but when I met them closely, I was surprised that they were hard working but always very melancholy. Always singing songs of separation, this, that, all kinds of very melancholy songs. So one need not be melancholy at all. So the first condition is that you have to forgive yourself and be very confident about yourself, that you, all of you, will get your realization. I promise you that. The second thing, second condition is that you have to forgive everyone. Whether you forgive or don't forgive, you don't do anything. It is another myth. But if you don't forgive, then you play into wrong hands. You torture yourself. But just now, at this moment, this center on the optic chiasma is constricted like this. And if you don't forgive, it won't open. And this kundalini won't be able to rise. So, as it is, you have tortured yourself all your life, and now at this great moment, you will be missing your self-realization. So, best is to forgive everyone. Don't even think about them whom you have to forgive. The third condition is simplest, is we have to take out our shoes. Because first time in England, when I asked them to take out the shoes, they all walked off. They are so much attached to their shoes. But in the Japanese tradition, they take out shoes for respectability. And also, the Mother Earth helps you very much. Please take out your shoes and keep them on side, both the feet, because these are two powers within us. You don't have to go to Himalaya, stand on your head, fast, do anything of the kind. It will all work out here now. Still, I would request some of you to come here. In front would be better. At the back side, can you come this side? There are some seats. This one seat. Yeah, yeah. Here there are some seats. Thank you very much. I know a little bit Japanese, so I should say domo arigato gozaimasu ka. I learnt it long time back. Just here also. Here you can. Now, you need not write anything. This is only tonight you have to do all this. All of you have to do it. Because I respect your freedom. If you don't want to have it, you should leave the hall. But don't disturb people when they are just about to get their realization. But there should be one promise that once you get your realization, you are going to grow into it. Now, as I told you, the left and right side are two powers. One is of desire and another of action. So keep your feet apart from each other. You should sit straight, not slouch or go back, but sit straight, comfortably, comfortably. Now, put your left hand towards me like this, which is symbolic that you desire, not like this on your lap, that you are desirous to have your Self-realization. Now the right hand we'll use for our action. Action to nourish our centers on the left-hand side. So now we'll show you what is to be done. Will you come up? Now, please put your right hand on your heart and left hand like this throughout. Now, in the heart resides the spirit. Now, if you become the spirit, you become your own guide, your own master. So please take your right hand in the upper portion of your abdomen on the left hand side. Upper portion of your abdomen on the left hand side. This is the center of your mastery. Within a month, you become a master. Sometimes people become within a week. Now, please take down your right hand in the low portion of your abdomen on the left hand side. You'll be amazed to know that this is the center of the pure divine knowledge. Now, please raise your right hand in the upper portion of your abdomen. Again. Now on the heart. Now in the corner of your neck and shoulder, and turn your head to your right. Now, this is the center I've told you about. Please put the hand from the front. Front side. Like this. Not like that, like this. Turn your head to your right. This is the center when we get guilt, gets into trouble. You can take out your glasses. It might help your eyesight also. Japanese eat too much of fish, that's why their eyesight is weak. But with Sahaja Yoga you can get rid of your glasses. I never had glasses till about 5 years back when this light all the time on my face, I developed problems. All right. Now please put your right hand on top of your head, on top of your forehead, and put down your head. This is the center where you have to forgive everyone without thinking about them, in general. Now, take back your right hand on the back side of your head and push back your head as far as possible. This is the center where, without feeling guilty, without counting your mistakes, you will have to ask forgiveness from the all-pervading divine power. Push back. Yeah. Now, the last center is the most important one. You stretch your palm fully. Stretch your palm fully. It's very important. Stretch it. And now put it on top of the fontanel bone area, which was a soft bone in your childhood. Now the most important thing is push back your fingers. Please put down your head. Put down your head. Please put down your head. Push back your fingers. There should be a good pressure on your scalp. Now move your scalp, not the hand so much as the scalp, 7 times slowly clockwise. Bend your head. Not the hand, the scalp. Push back your fingers, push back. Now, this is all we have to do. You can go now. It's all right. You can. Now, please. Now, please put your left hand again towards me like this, carefully. And both the feet apart from each other. Please take it out. Now we have to close our eyes. Take it down. Take it down. No, take it down. Yeah. Now put the left hand on your lap. See that your both feet are apart from each other. Now put your right hand on your heart. Take out your glasses, it's better. Because now you have to close your eyes. And please don't open them till I tell you. Please put it on the heart. Close your eyes, please. Now here you have to ask a very fundamental question about yourself in your heart. You can call me Sri Mataji or Mother, whatever you like.
Mother, or Sri Mataji,
or So now please ask a question three times in your heart. Mother, am I the spirit? Ask this question three times in your heart. Please put your hand on your heart. And ask the question. Three times, Mother, am I the spirit? Now, please take down this right hand in the upper portion of our abdomen. Don't open your eyes. Now, press it here. And ask another fundamental question about yourself. Mother, am I my own guide, my own master? I have already told you that I respect your freedom. And I cannot force pure divine knowledge on you. You have to ask for it. So please take your right hand in the low portion of your abdomen and press it hard. Here you have to ask me six times, because this center has got six petals. Please say, ask, Mother, please give me the pure divine knowledge, six times. As soon as you ask for the pure divine knowledge, the kundalini starts moving upward. So now we have to enrich our higher centers with our self-confidence to open them. Please take your right hand now in the upper portion of your abdomen and press it hard. Here, you have to say with full self-confidence 10 times, Mother, I am my own master. Please say 10 times. Now, please raise your right hand on your heart. I have already told you at the very outset that you are the pure spirit. So now here you have to say with self-confidence 12 times, Mother, I am the pure spirit. Now, raise your hand on to the into the corner between your neck and shoulder and press it and put your head towards right. I have already told you about this center. When you feel guilty, it goes into Jeopardy. So you have to forgive yourself. Because this all-pervading power is the ocean of forgiveness. It will dissolve all your guilt. So here 16 times you have to say, Mother, I am not guilty at all. Say it 16 times. I have already told you that whether you forgive or don't forgive, you don't do anything. And if you do not forgive at this moment, your Ajna Chakra won't open. So now please raise your right hand on top of your forehead across and put down your head. Here you have to say from your heart, not how many times. Please put down your head as far as possible. Please put down. Here you have to say from your heart, not how many times, Mother, I forgive everyone in general. Now, without feeling guilty, without counting your mistakes, you have to ask forgiveness from the all-pervading divine power for your own satisfaction. So now please take your right hand on the back side of your head and push back your head. Here you have to say without feeling guilty, without counting your mistakes, O divine power, if I have done anything wrong, please forgive me. You have to say this from your heart, not how many times. Now, the last center, which is very important, please stretch your palm fully. Now please bend your head as far as possible. And put the center of your palm on top of the fontanelle bone area. Please bend your head, bend your head. On the fontanelle bone area, is the top.
Where?
Yes. No, no, not on the back, but on top. Please put it on top. Yeah. On top, not on the back. Yeah. Now, stretch back your fingers. Put down your head. Here again, I cannot force self-realization on you. You have to ask for it. So now move your scalp with a little pressure, saying in your heart 7 times, Mother, give me self-realization. While moving the scalp 7 times, slowly, clockwise. Now take down your hands. Please open your eyes. Put both the hands towards me like this. Now put the right hand towards me like this, little higher. And bend your head and see with your hand if there's a cool or a hot breeze-like vibrations are coming out of your fontanelle bone area, your own. Bend, bend. Bend the head. Maybe hot. If you have not forgiven, that it would be hot. Forgive yourself and forgive others. Now, please put the left hand towards me. Now, don't doubt that there is air conditioning. It's coming out of your own head. Now, please put your left hand towards me and put the right hand again on the fontanelle bone area and bend your head. Sometimes it comes very close to the head, sometimes far away. So move your hand and see for yourself. All right, now put again once more. Right hand towards me, bend your head and see for yourself if there's a cool or a hot breeze coming out of your fontanelle bone area. Now put both the hands towards me again like this. Now watch me without thinking. Can you do it? Now you have to put both your hands towards the sky like this and push back your head. Here you have to ask three times one of these three questions. First is, Mother, is this the cool breeze of the Holy Ghost described in the Bible? Mother, is this the cool breeze of Maitreya as described by Buddha? Third one is to ask, Mother, is this the all-pervading power of divine love called as Ru in Quran? Any one of these questions you can ask three times. Now please put down your hands. Please put down your hands. Please put them down. Please. All those who have felt cool breeze on your fingertips or on your palms, or out of fontanelle bone area, whether cool or hot, you have to raise both your hands. Both your hands. Higher. You didn't feel? All right. I bow to all of you. Most of the people have felt it. One or two. You didn't feel the cool breeze or a hot breeze in your hand? One or two. You did. What about you? All right, one or two persons. Doesn't matter. Now, this is for the first time you have felt the all-pervading power of divine love. Try to understand. Now you have got your self-realization. But don't waste it. You'll find there's a tinkling in your eyes, a light will come in your eyes. Also, you can feel your in with your friends, so you can find out if they're cool or not.
Yeah.
So we have to grow. And luckily now we have a center in Japan which is not very elaborate, but to begin with is very good.
日本にはサガジヨガのセンターがあります。 まだ大きくありませんけれども
。And we have some good sahajogis.
サハジョギーとしていい人たちもいます。
Here, some of them have come from abroad.
外国人もいます。
But I know once Japanese grow into their spirituality, they can go abroad.
日本人もスピリチュアリティで成長すれば、
they can do a lot of good.
世界中でいろいろなことができると思います。
Now you'll be amazed how your creativity will improve, how your illnesses will go away, how you will feel relaxed.
想像力が増進し、健康が改善し、そしてどうリラックスできると、平安が得られるということにびっくりすると思います。
Also you prosper very much.
そしてまた経済的にもまた。
Because your attention becomes very concentrated.
経済的にもまた成功するわけです。つまり注意力が非常に
develop that wisdom, that balance.
バランスの取れた知恵ができるからです。
And you start enjoying yourself.
そして自分自身を楽しむことができ始めるのです。
So the greatest thing of the spirit is that it is the source of enjoyment.
聖霊の素晴らしさは喜びの源だということです。
You cannot get enjoyment from others. If the source is within yourself.
他の源から喜びを得ることはできません。それは自分自身の中にある。
So you enjoy yourself.
で自分を。
That's all is my message. I'm sure I'll come next year again.
再び来年来ることをきっとお約束します。
But before that, you try to be collective.
どうかコレクティブ、集団で、いるようにしてみてください。
It's a collective happening, not individual.
個人のことであるというよりも集団で大事な意味を持っています
。As we are part and parcel of the whole.
全体の一部であるから、全体の一部であるから集団が大事なのです。
You have so many brothers and sisters all over the world.
世界中にたくさんの兄弟姉妹がいます。
You are not alone now.
もうあなた方は一人ではありません。
So may God bless you.
神の祝福がありますように。
Again, どうもありがとうございますか。
ひとしさんいますか。フォローアップの話をしてください。
フォローアップについて説明します。3月の8日から来週の水曜日から毎週水曜日と
Now enjoy yourself. Enjoy.
肝臓の問題ですね。だから、
on the right side. It's all right. It will be cured. It will be cured, even if it is hot.
治します。
フォローアップ毎週水曜日と金曜日に。